That's like the most powerful weed whip I've seen.
Dude, yeah, without a doubt.
And cordless. That was weird.
Because when this more power it kicks in.
What's up, you guys? Tools in Action. Today, it's a great day here in Chicago. It's September, end of September. What's the date? The 25th. It's end of September, so it's like, you know, just fall is about to set in.
Even though it's 95 degrees here today.
95 degrees. We haven't been able to mow in like a month, but obviously today we got to mow Yard Force, you guys. We've talked to you about Yard Force before, and, you know, we're pretty happy with their stuff. They are an advertiser of Tools in Action, just so you guys know, but they, you know, we've been pretty happy with their pressure washers and stuff, and they kind of told us, hey, we're coming out with this 120 volt lineup, and I'm like, ah, yeah, right, whatever. I mean, 120 volt, that's the same voltage you get when you plug into an AC outlet, right? So we got the mower today, we got the blower, and we got the string trimmer, and a few surprises actually about the equipment, and we're gonna kind of just go over, you guys, give you a basic rundown on what it is and how it works. So we'll start with the mower. What do you think?
I like it. I mean, there's things on here that usually we've seen a lot of mowers be cheap, like handles. Usually they're really cheap. This one I like, nice handle. I like the gauges. They actually feel smooth, you know? I don't know if you call them gauges, whatever they call them, you know?
Yeah, that's not a gauge. It's a lever, Eric.
Lever, thank you, yeah.
Stop watching now. Yeah. Whoever's watching, they're like, oh my God, no.
It's got a metal deck, which, you know, definitely adds weight, adds durability to it, but it definitely adds weight compared to some of the other ones we tested. But compared to the other things we've tested out this year, this is probably one of the nicest mowing, you know, like finish like
when cut.
A lot of the ones we've tested in the past, it pushes a lot of, it does cut, but it'll push a lot of the grass down, so the next day you see, this one doesn't, you can actually see, we actually scalped a lot of the grass pretty low, and it does a nice job cutting all the grass. You don't leave much behind, I like that.
Yeah, like Eric said, I mean, we're pretty happy with the build quality of it. Steel deck does make it heavy. That's the only knock I have against this.
I got two other knocks too.
But it's fast. You know,
when it
you
is
hit
fast.
That, I mean, it's one of the fastest push motors I've seen.
Yep.
As far as
self-propelled
goes. You know, I mean, the hubcaps got hubcaps on it, but
That's cool.
Yeah, I like the big handle too to adjust it, because usually it's just a handle. This is actual nice grab handle that you can lift
and
up.
And it'll do all four wheels at one time.
Yeah,
so.
Which is cool, and it's kind of cool because the engine, it looks like an engine. Kinda,
yeah, actually
doesn't
it does.
But
it's
all
funny
that stuff kind of looks like it has a little gas engine on it. But it's 3-in-1, so it does mulch, side discharge, and bag. What do you think?
Yeah, the two other knocks I have on it is a long time for it to actually start up. I mean, all the battery-powered stuff we've ever tested, there's always a lag to start up. This one seems a little bit longer than normal. Not a huge deal, because honestly, once with a lawnmower, once you start it, you pretty much keep it going. You don't do that. The only other thing I'd like to see is I don't really use self-propelled that much, you know. I'd like to see this maybe down a little bit lower in a different place, because as I'm mowing, I notice this pushes against my wrist a little bit, you know.
Right.
Not a huge deal.
If you don't use the self-propelled.
If you don't use the self-propelled.
But I feel with this mower, you're going to use the self-propelled. It's just, it was easy to use.
It does help because it is a little bit heavier, so the self-propelled is
and
nice.
And as for the slow start, all the brushless stuff starts slow.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, you know, you get it and it goes, you know, you maybe get a 5-second delay before you get that full power. And another cool thing was this is the first time I actually heard it. Was when you were mowing and it kicked in higher.
Yes, yeah, definitely.
Because it detected that, hey, I'm under a lot of stress workload here, so I'm gonna go higher.
So it basically makes your runtime a lot longer, so when it doesn't need it, it's not gonna push out all that amps or all that power.
Right. The batteries, you guys, are kind of cool. They got little handles on them, which kind of, you know, it's kind of a nice little feature. It's got a little magnet. It magnets it down. But it's to pull them out and put them in, I mean, it's easier. It's kind of cool.
Yeah, I like it.
I mean, imagine if you go back way back in the days to, like, futuristic stuff. This is how you see power packs.
Yeah, right, yeah,
you know,
exactly.
You always imagine
them
with a handle.
Put them in your spaceship and pull them out.
So it's like, oh, we got to put a new power pack in it. So
overall, for me, the bottom two things is durability. It seems like it has. The metal deck's going to have that. And the cut quality, I think, is awesome. So, I mean, it's got those two things.
Yeah, easy lever to fold forward, and the bag is pretty good.
That's a good point. That bag is nice. We've seen a lot of junky bags where you can just tell that they're going to give away within a year or two. This one's solid, the way it's shaped with the plastic.
And easy to connect. Yeah, easy to connect. And last but not least, it does need both batteries to operate. So that's cool. Next in the lineup, let's go into a little bit here, is the blower. What'd you think of the blower?
Blower's nice. I mean, it's not the most powerful one we've used. I like it. It's a little bit on the heavy side, but I think it's still pretty good.
Right. You know? I agree with Eric. It's a heavy blower. It does get the job done. I mean, you guys, every OPE brand that's out there, they can't have the best of everything, you know? Some of their stuff is just okay. Even tool companies, you know? Like DeWalt. I love DeWalt a lot, right?
Yep.
But they don't have the best in everything. Milwaukee doesn't have the best. Bosch doesn't have the best in everything. So I think...
Whoa, slow down about Bosch.
What?
No, I'm just...
No, you know what I'm saying. But the blower, definitely, if you have this lineup, it's definitely something to look into. It's, you know, I mean, it's not the worst blower we've ever tested.
No,
it's not the best blower. It's right in the middle.
But it's a good blower.
Yeah, it's a good blower. And it just, you know, it was pretty powerful. Not the most powerful we've seen, though. And like I said, the weight situation, I just felt like it was a little back heavy for me. But it does come with a strap that you can strap it. Mm-hmm. So if you are a homeowner and you do use it a lot.
If you're not a homeowner, you can still use it like that.
No, you can't. No, you can't.
But it does, I don't know if we mentioned, it does have three speeds, which is nice. So if you're on a flower bed, you're not pushing all the mulch and everything out of the way, so.
Right. And last but not least, you guys, the brushless string trimmer. Now, this thing is a beast.
This thing is powerful.
By far is the most powerful string trimmer we have ever tested here at Tools in Action. I mean, it is so powerful that even Eric said, whoa. I need glasses and pants for this one.
Yeah, because I got it. In all honesty, this is bad. I shouldn't have made this, but a lot of times when I'm weed whipping, I'm in shorts. I don't have my glasses on. Sometimes I'm even in, like, just walking around barefoot. I know you're not supposed to do it, whatever, but definitely not this. I'd wear long pants and glasses because this thing is powerful.
Yeah, this thing is a beast, you guys. I mean, this is powerful as any gas I've ever seen. I mean, as soon as we started going, I mean, it's shooting stuff everywhere, taking down whatever's in its path. It does have three speeds, luckily, so if you don't need that full power, you can dial it down a little bit.
Hey, can you go tell these guys to shut up? We're filming.
I know. What the heck? We got tree work going on behind us, you guys. We apologize. But definitely, man, if you guys are looking for the most powerful string trimmer you can get in electric, this is it by far.
This
thing is insane. Same thing, though. Oh, there's no battery in it. It does have that delayed ramp-up time. But, you know, overall, it's pretty well balanced. I mean, this is a nice string trimmer. And again, looks like a gas motor on the back, which is kind of, you know, something cool that they added.
Yeah.
As far as durability, it's about the same as every other one you're going to see on the market. You know, a lot of polymer. It's got an aluminum frame or aluminum shaft, which I like to see, you know. And you can either easily take it apart for storage, just undo this here, pull the pin, and then this comes right out. And seeing that it does have that gear system in it, maybe in the future they're going to come with different heads
point.
For it.
Yeah,
maybe,
point.
Possibly. I don't know. But overall, you guys, this is the first yard for stuff we've seen as far as OPE goes. I know it's the end of the year, but we're really excited to start showing this stuff off in summer. We're going to give it to Bodie a test.
Yep.
And we'll get reports back from him next year. But overall, good stuff. Definitely, you know, something to take a look at. And the good thing about YardMax is their prices.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, you're not going to get robbed. They're not expensive. They're right on with the other brands. If you buy this, you know, I can guarantee you're going to have no problems, no quarrels. So.
And if they do, what's your guarantee to them?
Call Eric.
If there's a problem,
you call Eric and blame him. Chevy Chase. You guys, Tools in Action, hashtag TIA crew wherever you go. Don't forget TIA gear. As you can see, we are such proponents of TIA gear that we wear it all the time.
Exactly. You can see this over TIA gear all the time. Hey, that's another thing I noticed on this actual steel deck. It's nice. Right around the sides where you normally hit, like, rocks when you're going around, there's a plastic piece around there. That's pretty nice, so it actually protects the metal and it's not going to get bent up.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I didn't notice that.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of thought went into this mower, and it's... Underneath the guts, it's all built really good. I mean, just the steel, I can see the steel axles and stuff like that. I mean, you know, obviously it's got the hubcaps on it and everybody laughs at the hubcaps, but it's definitely...
Well, it's like the hubcaps I got in my truck. What's wrong with that?
Okay. Tools in Action, you guys. Check it out.
For more exciting tool action, go to toolsinaction.com.